Anyways, we'll see what happens with this fucking lady. this fucking lady.
And all of her toot.
Well, let's if you want to get into shit like that, we can talk about fucking Mrs. Kathleen Kennedy.
Oh my god.
And her abuse of Mr. Harrison Ford, who was seen in London with a sling. With a fucking
elderly
sling.
Abuse.
Her abuse of an elderly man. Alright, we're back. It's a fucking Friday, July 23rd. Did I get it right?
Yep.
Ah,
you did.
I think I'm going to be getting it right from now on, though. They're making me write it at my new job a lot.
Good.
But anyways, cheers, motherfuckers! You get
cheers.
Alright, let's get into it, because we got a lot of shit to fucking talk about, man. Let's start with the motherfucking comments, you know how we do. And we're gonna start with motherfucking Gomer fucking Kyle. And you know, he's rolled all and he's talking about fucking the rapist, not the rapist, the child molester, fucking, Drake Bell. Says they gave him 2 freaking years probation. What the fuck? Dan Schneider, which is that fat dude who used to have Rundle shows, and he molested and tormented all those kids, including Amanda Bynes. All those kids are fucked up because of that fat piece of shit, Dan Schneider. It doesn't matter. He ruined the Nickelodeon kids. Yes, he did. I know he did. All those kids are fucked up because of this guy, Drake Bell, even though he is a pervert, but he's probably a pervert because he hung out with that fat fuck. hey, that's why Nickelodeon got rid of him. They're all like, we don't want this guy. He's a liability, especially in this cancel culture. We don't need a fucking guy like that employed here. So they fired his fucking fat ass. but he has plenty of money, so he's going to stay fat. Don't worry, guys. Anyways, he said, I love Rob Zombie. Halloween is my favorite movie of all time. The 78 one, not his remake. Yeah, let's just hope Rob doesn't turn the monsters into a redneck family yelling fuck 100 times a minute like a Rob Zombie movie. I can just imagine.
Fuck, dude, really? I would watch that. I would fucking watch that too.
Some devil rejects fucking monsters. That'd be fucking
dude,
crazy.
Make it serious? Like, yeah. Oh, that would be cool.
He says he'll have fucking Eddie Munster yelling fuck, raising hell, and drinking blood out of his schoolmates and teachers. As always, Puff Puff give and cheers.
Cheers,
Kyle,
man.
You know you're the shit, bro. We appreciate you. You know what it is. We have another crazy motherfucker. I like this guy's name a lot. He goes, his name is Rocco Fuck My Life. And this motherfucker says, I thought the villain was going to be another Loki too. He's talking about the final episode finale of Loki,
yeah.
As we talked about on the last episode. I only hope I can play the majority of the games on that Steam Dock thing. I've been thinking about that myself, you know, because, I mean, I think most games are on PC anyways, you know, so at least you'll get the you know, you won't get exclusives, you won't get to play Spider-Man PS4 or fucking God of War, but you'll get to play every other game, I think, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, most of them, because of Steam, they're going to be in you're able to play them on your computer. Whether it be on an emulator, which we don't condemn, whatever you do.
I do. I support that kind of shit.
I mean, I own whatever I emulate. So.
Anyways. He says, cheers, my dudes, and keep up the good work. Cheers, Rocco, fuck my life.
Cheers, bro.
You know what it is, bro. Then we had our good friend, motherfucking Robo. We're giving everybody the horn today, just so everybody knows. he said he had a long overtime weekend, bros, because he saw our video late. It's all good, dude. He goes, dude, Dwayne will be the first roided out president of the free world. I'll vote for him. Cheers, Kike and son. Dude,
nice.
Dwayne
Cheers.
Johnson would be a scary fucking president. Not just because he's ginormous. He's a pretty much a walking tumor. But because if that happens, no, not if. When that happens, we are officially in the fucking idiocracy timeline.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. President Dwayne, Alejandro Camacho.
Camacho!
Camacho, motherfuckers. Hey, cheers, Robo! You know what it is, bro.
Cheers, man. My drink has electrolytes.
Hey, fuck your electrolytes. It's what your body needs. And then we got, last but not least, Eddie Molina Vilches. And he says, what up, my favorite wisecracking jokers? Hey, I've been commenting on every podcast, and I don't hear you guys read my comments. Out of every week, I watch your show, so them cock creatures at YouTube must be blocking my comments. They need to stop letting the AI run control of YouTube's comments, comments and everything. Keep up the good work. What does he say? Oh, sorry, I lost place. Whatever else it does, because soon it's going to take over everything. I think it will. Keep up the good work, and hopefully hear you guys mention my comment on the next video. Cheers, my brownskis. Well, we got this comment.
We got that one.
We got this one. If y'all don't know, you get censored in our channel, which is why a lot of these motherfuckers right here, they misspell their bad words or make spaces in between bad words and shit like that, because you'll get flagged, and then all of a sudden your comments won't even come out on our videos anymore for whatever reason.
Yeah.
It'll say that we have like 13 comments, but we can only see like 6 or some bullshit. Fuck you, YouTube and Google, cocksuckers. cheers, fucking Vilches. You know what it is.
Cheers, bro.
All right. Let's get into it, bro. We got a lot of news this week. We're going to just... Let's talk about the elephant in the room. COVID is still around.
Yeah.
And no one is giving a fuck because, like, my friend down here told me before we got online, it's all right, I'm vaccinated. You dumbass.
You think, fuck you, you piece of shit.
What? You think people who get the flu vaccine don't catch the flu?
Yeah, it's a variation.
Exactly. I mean, look, there's going to be... This thing's here forever, you dumb sons of bitches. And every year, there's going to be 2 or 3 different strains. And every year, whether you get a vaccine or not, you're probably going to catch it. All you got to do is either wear a mask if you're going somewhere where you're going to be literally close to people.
Mm-hmm.
Or... just don't go somewhere where you're going to be really close to people.
Yep.
And if you do have to go somewhere to go grocery shopping or whatever, when you get home, take a shower, wash your hands, don't touch your face. I mean, it's not that hard, you fucking idiots. It's not that hard. But unfortunately, everyone has this mentality that as long as you're vaccinated, you're good. But now it's starting to affect Hollywood again. Netflix's show in Bridgerton had an outbreak, and they're shut down. Also from Netflix, Matilda the Musical also caught on that outbreak because, you know, there's a bunch of fucking kids and they're all dirty and shit. And boom, now they're shut down. Believe it or not, but HBO Max's House of the Dragon, the spinoff from Game of Thrones, boom, shut down, motherfucker. And it's not stopping there, all right? Because we got American Horror Story from FX, boom, shut down because of COVID. Overseas, man, it's getting crazy in the UK because now we have even the hit musical Cinderella, Andrew Lloyd Webber's, who was fucking pissed when it got shut down because of COVID because he saw all the money he wasn't going to get. Greedy son of a bitch. But now the movie studios over there said we're not even the Green Knight was about to premiere a week or two from now. Boom. It's been delayed. Shut down from premiering because they want to make their money. They want to make their Sean Penn. I forget what the fuck he was filming, but he has refused to even go back to set until every member, cast, crew, every backstage hand is vaccinated. He's not even showing
up. Old.
Yeah.
He'll get sick like that.
Yeah. But it's coming. It's getting even worse, man, because people are not taking this shit serious, because now we even had Nike's second biggest supplier of shoes in the world in South Korea. Boom. The plant is shut down. There's going to be a Nike shortage now. LeBron and
people are not going to get going to go even more.
Crazier.
Up. Yeah.
People are going to start robbing people for shoes. Stick, give me your shoes. Yeah, it's going to get bad out there, man. People are going to start getting desperate. Look, all we're trying to say, look, I'm trying to make this political. We don't want to go into vaccinations and all that bullshit. But, you know, just fucking wash your hands and, you know... If you're going to go to a concert, I don't know, man. I would think about maybe getting a vaccine, a couple of them, before you go.
Wear a suit. Yeah. Hazmat suits, some shit like that. I don't know.
Look, man, I love wrestling, man, and they've come to my town already twice, and I can't. I mean, I'm not going to. I mean, that's just me.
Yeah.
Ugh. Yeah. Anyways, let's move on to some more news, because I started following this guy on Instagram. Thank God, man. Rob Zombie is a shit. He's posting more images of the Munsters, you know, other shit too, but he posted the mold and the wig, the wig for Grandpa, and the mold for Herman's forehead. My question is, if they're making the mold for the forehead, does he already have the actor?
I'm pretty sure they do. I mean, they need to have their fucking the sculpture of their head they can... you know, molded around their fucking facial features and whatnot.
I was trying to figure out by looking at this who the actor was, but I don't fucking know.
Yeah.
It's probably some
glad he's going old school with this, like with practical fucking effects. That's pretty cool.
It's Rob Zombie. That's what he does.
Yeah.
He likes fucking crazy ass things like this. But it's just like Gomer Kyle said, are we going to see the old Munsters funny and goofy being white? Or are we going to see fucking Herman Monster fucking killing people and shit?
That'd be cool too.
And Lily covered in blood, naked.
I bet you want to see that.
No, that'll ruin my childhood. Shit. You know what? Speaking of fucking ruining my childhood, I haven't seen it yet, but apparently the Masters of the Universe sucks.
Oh, what? The cartoon series that is going to come out?
That already came out, you ass. You've been on vacation and you haven't...
Oh, yeah.
The world has moved. The world has moved while you've been getting yourself in danger.
I got some color too, bro. I got a lot of vitamin D.
What the fuck? We were born brown. We don't need no more fucking vitamin D in our system.
No, it's the opposite way, but I'll explain later.
Yeah. Anyways, on Rotten Tomatoes... the fucking the score is like a 95%. It's freshly approved. The audience from the critics.
Mm-hmm,
the audience score is like less than 25.
Wow. Have you seen it?
No, but I've read all the comments. Mm-hmm. And here is what people are pissed off about.
And why
you're about to get pissed off. In the very first episode, He-Man and Skeletor die, and you don't see them again. Anymore. And the rest of the series is about Teela.
What?
Yes.
Like in the first episode, they get killed off.
What was the last thing I said when I was super drunk and you thought I was being sexist or racist or some shit? I said, you know what? If they make a He-Man, it's probably going to be She-Man in this generation. Well, that's exactly what Kevin Smith did. He killed off He-Man in the first episode and gave the series to the girl.
Wow, I don't want to believe you. I'm going to Google this. Oh, it's true.
I don't want to fucking... I'm not going to watch this. You ruined my childhood. Kevin Smith, what's wrong with you? I thought you were one of us. You're from the same generation. I was like, this motherfucker knows He-Man because he grew up with it. But apparently, the son of a bitch probably never even saw the show.
Holy shit. Well, I haven't seen it, so let's hope. And you haven't seen it either.
I don't care. I'm not going to. Because everybody on Rotten Tomatoes, all the comments are talking bullshit about this.
Well, fuck. Now I want to see it to see if it's true. I kind of don't want to believe you. Jesus.
You have Mark Hamill being Skeletor, and he's only there for the first episode because he dies. And He-Man 2, he dies. And the rest of the episode is the girl who takes over as the new He-Man, She-Man. The girl.
But
the powerful,
she already got a series on Netflix.
The more powerful. What are you talking about? Teela has a series on Netflix?
Yeah, like a cartoon series before this, way before this.
No, that was She-Ra. That was He-Man's sister or cousin or whatever the fuck it was. This is Teela. Right. This is the psychic, the girl that's always there trying to protect Prince Adam.
Hmm.
Yeah, they fucked
everyone. Well, that's a bummer.
They fucked everyone. I don't know if this is Kevin Smith. Just not knowing what He-Man and Masters of the Universe is,
or if this is come on, he has to know.
I don't know. People are saying that he never even watched the show, and he used to say he wasn't into He-Man. They've gone back to interviews where he says, "I've never been into He-Man." So yeah, maybe he didn't know, or this is the studio saying, look, man, we don't want a blonde, muscled, blue-eyed, fucking lead character. You need to kill him and put a girl who's strong and right. If you're done being racist, what the fuck, man? They fucked this shit up. Kevin Smith, what do you think it was? You think the studio forced him to make this?
Look, Kevin Smith doesn't bend to shit like that, bro.
So he made this about a girl.
If he did it, he did it intentionally, right? Now, why did he do it? And again, I still don't believe it. Fuck. If this is true, it's because he has a daughter. You know? And he's like, what's more, whatever, than my daughter? It's a
one of the comments that I read there. One of the comments that I read on fucking Rotten Tomatoes was from a female our age who says she grew up watching the cartoons. And that she goes, I'm a woman, and I got mad that you killed He-Man in the first episode. He goes, my daughters just got up and said, can we just go play outside? And I said, yeah, this is not even what I grew up with. I wanted to share something with you, but I don't know what the fuck this is. And she walked away with her kids to go play outside instead. That was her comment there, man.
Wow.
Kevin Smith, no one from this generation knows He-Man. So your money was going to be from people like us. And then you fucked it up? I don't understand. Anyways, I'm fucking pissed. But we're going to move on to something that I guess is going to cheer me up just because I'm fucking a lot of you nerds over. But Nintendo has officially come out and say they have no plans to ever release another version of the Switch or a Switch Pro. Because they keep getting asked questions about the Steam Deck and then when is their Switch Pro that's better is going to come out. And they had to just come out and say, hey, we never said it with the Switch Pro. We don't have no intentions to make another system, another Nintendo Switch, another Switch Pro. There's nothing coming.
Dude, Shigeru Miyamoto's rolling in his own grave. Damn, bro. Oh my god, Nintendo.
They're digging their own grave. They are digging their own fucking grave. Nintendo.
Wow.
Is Nintendo. You have Mario and Donkey Kong, all the characters in it.
They're getting cocky, dude.
They only care about their Japanese people. That's all they care about. They don't care about Americans. This is what Americans want. We want the Steam Deck. And you know what? Fuck it. You might as well call it the Steam Dick. So that way we can show those Japanese that we have the better fucking
and shove
shit.
Them up their ass.
We have the bigger dick. We have the bigger dick, motherfucker. Your little Switch ain't shit. You know, like, I had so much hope in Nintendo because I, you know, the only reason, honestly, I even fucking have Nintendo for any reason at all is because of Zelda. That's the only thing that keeps me buying their goddamn system is because I want to play those games, the Zelda games. They're amazing. But their hardware.
Yeah.
Their hardware used to be innovating. It used to be the next leap, what everyone needed to catch up to. Their hardware has become into gimmicks.
Yeah.
They have like cardboard boxes they'll sell you for $30 to play with.
You know what? In a way, it's contradictory. Like, the make of the actual Switch is kind of... No, it's not kind of flimsy. It is flimsy. It doesn't look like it's going to last that long. Because kids, it's designed for kids. Yet the fucking video game card is small enough for a kid to choke on it. Which, I'm actually surprised nobody has choked on that shit, knowing that kids are so fucking stupid nowadays.
Let me see how many I can eat and then throw up.
Let's see if I can go into this game. Yeah, dude. It's disappointing, for sure. Fucking, I was expecting something better. Better graphics. A better docking system, you know. I mean, that's all I wanted. You can keep the same design. I don't give a fuck about the fucking
screen.
Well, guess
what? You're not getting it. Nintendo.
Yeah,
said,
I know.
Nintendo said that's it. It's over. Go home. You gave us your money, and that's all we wanted.
There's a lot of disappointed people like that are in the actual Nintendo fucking verse.
Yeah.
That are like commenters and whatnot. And I don't blame them. I'm also upset, you know?
let's move on, because, you know, it's about time everybody sees them for what they are. Let's move on. Disappointments. Something that didn't disappoint, for fuck's sakes, was the goddamn Dune trailer, bro. And I know you saw it. Don't fucking lie to me, you piece of shit.
Yeah, I saw it. It looks cool.
It looks amazing.
It looks cool. It's not amazing.
Well, that's because, you know what?
I'll
you
say
haven't
it's
read the
amazing.
Book. You haven't read the book.
No, you I'm haven't on my either. Second. You I'm read on my, the whole book?
I'm on my second. Yeah, I'm on my second reading, you ass.
Whatever.
I've read
I don't
it
care
high
about
school,
the book.
Well,
I care about the graphics, and I care about the fucking picture. I don't care about reading.
Well, what did you think of the trailer, Mr. Fucking I Don't Know Nothing About Dune?
I know the lore. I don't know anything about... Well, I know about the story, too.
What did you think of the trailer?
The trailer looks good. It doesn't look fucking fantastic. Oh. Honestly, it does not. It
look,
does not.
This is for people who don't know what Dune is. Dune is not Star Wars. It's not Marvel. It's kind of boring if you don't get into it. I was reading the book. The book obviously details and they write it in a way that draws you in and you get excited because you're reading a story. This is a movie. For people who haven't read the book and they're probably going to see the movie, I promise you they're going to say this movie was fucking boring. But me,
yeah,
I've read the
book.
Especially
if you see the 1984 fucking picture, I mean, it was boring.
Do not. Let me just tell everyone who has not seen it: do not go back and see the 1984 picture. It has nothing to do with the book. I promise you.
Yeah.
It's nothing. This is he's following the book, the descriptions that the book describes. This is the way it's supposed to look. This is amazing. The question from that here is that, especially towards the end, I wonder is this really a really long movie? Is this going to be a to be continued? I think it's going to be a to be continued. But we see scenes that are like from the second book and shit.
Yeah. It's Hollywood. They're going to condense it into one movie.
It's too big. The story's too big for one movie. I think, this is what I think, those scenes, especially at the end when you see him fighting in the gold suit and shit, those scenes, I think, are visions that he's having of the future, which is actually going to happen.
Or they're doing a Marvel and putting shit that is not going to be in the movie so they can lure you in to see the movie. And then there's, you know, if it does well enough,
they make the next one.
They make the next one.
The sad part is it's not going to do that good.
You know, Back to the Future did that. There was no Back to the Future 2 at the end of the fucking movie. That was on the VHS tapes. When you went to the fucking theater, you wouldn't see that. Right, they saw how good the movie was, and they were the original fucking franchise that did that before Marvel did that. And why not do it again? Like, I'm pretty sure they figured, like, hey, we can put shit in there so people can go watch it. And I mean, we won't put it on the final cut, but if it does well, we can start fucking doing it.
Look, I freaking love this. Look, this is the part I'm talking about at the end. You know, I think this is supposed to be from the second book and shit. When he's already like Jesus, and he knows he has all these powers and shit. But yeah, I think it's cool. I'm excited. I'm gonna use my VPN. You know what it is. But let's move on to some other shit, man. I don't even know how to start this. Mrs. Emily Blunt is beginning to take her name very serious nowadays.
She's smoking weed?
Maybe she is smoking weed, or I don't know. I don't know what the fuck's going on. But she's getting to be very blunt with her comments. Like, literally, she's being really blunt with her comments. You know, we've already heard that comment on the Howard Stern show on the last episode, episodes. Where
I wouldn't say honest, I would say
they have an interview about Jungle Cruise, her and Dwayne together. They were having an interview, and Dwayne goes, they were asking him, you know, since we're interviewing him, we might as well ask him about Black Adam, because he's posting a lot about it, and he's about to come out in that fucking movie. So they ask him a question, and he's trying to describe about Black Adam and Superman. And he goes, Black Adam has all the powers of Superman, but the difference is he's blessed with magic. And also, by a code of ethics in the world of superheroes, they don't kill the bad guys, but Black Adam does. There are a lot of elements like that that make me feel this is a real opportunity here. I feel like everything that I've done in the past in terms of my career, all the movies that I've done over the decades, even the ones that I didn't do as well, they all led to this particular role. And Emily Blunt is like, you know, like a little kid looking up at this giant. She goes, I really understand that the superhero movies are like a religion for a lot of people. They don't appeal to me in the same way. I don't have that burning desire to play a superhero.
Damn. What a way to fucking stab us in the heart.
Yeah, there was a rise in suicide cases that day. They found a bunch of nerds. They found a bunch of fucking nerds hung themselves.
They found fucking brains, blood, and pen holders.
Yeah.
Calculators.
Calculators everywhere. Bunch of fucking nerds. Damn, man. Either she doesn't give a fuck, or she's gonna be Mrs. Fantastic and she's just fucking with all of us, man.
She's just doing a fantastic work at acting.
She's gonna be like, you see, that's why they hired me.
It's called acting, baby.
It's called acting, motherfuckers. What do you think? You think she's legit? She doesn't give a fuck,
or
you think she's lying?
She's really hating on the whole thing.
She is.
Either she's like fucking exhausted about the same fucking question. Are you gonna be in this movie and this and that? And she is honestly fucking pissed off, or she's just having fun. Because imagine you already know you're this person, but they tell you not to do it, and they're like, okay, I'll tell them I'm not gonna be that person. I'm gonna be doing it, but I'm gonna have fun with it too. So I'm gonna be a total fucking asshole about it. And when it comes out, I'll be like, oh yeah, I was kidding.
Dude,
I would have done the same thing.
That's what I'm hoping for, man. I want her to be Mrs. Fantastic. I want fucking John Krasinski fucking being Mr. Fantastic. I want
Michael. Did they get her in camera? Like, did she say this on camera or no?
I don't know if this was on camera. It was on the Hollywood Reporter and shit.
Because I hope so, because then someone can fucking put a video edit. And then Krasinski, like, in the office going, like, looking at the camera.
That face. yeah, that'd be badass. Anyways, we'll see what happens with this fucking lady. this fucking lady.
And
dude!
Toot.
Well, let's tell you, if you want to get into shit like that, we can talk about fucking Mrs. Kathleen Kennedy.
Oh, my God.
And her abuse of Mr. Harrison Ford, who was seen in London with a sling. With a fucking
elderly
sling.
Abuse.
Her abuse of an elderly man. A tyrant.
Oh, my God.
Abusing this poor old man. This 80-year-old man forcing him to rehearse and do stunts and shit. Do flips and somersaults and dodge bullets and shit.
And remember that old man who was trying to train Jerry Seinfeld?
Yeah. You want to go?
Imagine this guy. You want to go? Come on, let's go right now. Oh, my God.
He's out.
He's out.
He's out. He said, we need to, they said, we can't afford to lose money because this motherfucker's injured. And so they're fucking, they're filming it with some guy wearing a mask, a Harrison Ford mask. And then they're going to digitally, like I said from the beginning, an 80-year-old man and there's a pandemic. He could get COVID and die on you too, you dumb assholes.
Oh,
why the
God.
Fuck do you even have him on set? You have the technology where you can scan his face, record his vocals, and he can still come out in the movie.
Yeah.
Fuck.
People don't take advantage of the fucking technology nowadays, man. What can I say?
Well, now they're being forced to spend the money the way they should have from the very beginning.
You know, it's just these executives, they don't fucking think. They don't know how to fucking think, bro. They're like, we're going to get Harrison Ford? Badass. And now they're like, oh, he's old. Old people are fragile. They can break. We can't have them make these stunts. We didn't do any stunts. Holy shit. Old people are fragile. We can't have them in this fucking movie. Yeah, bro. Oh, duh. Jesus. I'm glad he's out. out of the fucking movie doing this at least, because he was gonna die. This is gonna be his old, the last movie he was gonna do.
He was gonna die on set on them, and it was gonna be a huge liability, and Disney's credibility would have gone down.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing that this happened. Harrison Ford, God bless you, and cheers.
Imagine that lines, Mickey kills Han Solo again.
Oh my God. Again.
This time for real.
For real. So something crazy happened on the internet, dude.
What happened on Twitter,
apparently.
Uh-huh.
Charlie Cox was going to go to one of these celebrity fan fests, one of these Comic-Con knockoffs, you know.
Okay.
He's desperate for money, so he's like, "Yeah, I'll do it for a bag of cocaine." So he was going to go there and fucking, you know, be a celebrity. And he canceled last minute too. He just said, I can't show up, man. I'm sorry. And so he's not going to go anymore. And they said, don't worry. If you sent in an item, we'll get an autograph, and see if he still wants to, and he'll sign the shit for you. And the internet's going crazy because of this.
Okay. Do you think he's worried about fucking COVID? Is that why he fucking declined?
No. The internet is saying that apparently this is the exact same day they're having Spider-Man No Way Home reshoots.
Oh.
Boom. Yeah.
I was gonna ask, is he really blind? He doesn't know how to get there. Wow. Okay.
They're saying that Marvel called him back. That's a rumor to call them back, mm-hmm. so he can refilm some of those fucking shots. You know, being a lawyer defending Peter Parker and shit. So maybe they want to film a different ending or something.
Probably. Because look,
the beginning of the movie, regardless of the Spider-Verse and the Spider-Man and the villains from the other universes, realities, and the multiverse, the movie's gonna start off with the cops looking for Spider-Man. He's a wanted criminal. Yep. And it's going to have to end with Peter clearing his name.
Yeah.
All the other stuff is just the middle of the movie. I don't know how it's all going to tie together, but we'll see.
Defamation. I think it's going to be like the whole thing. Like, hey, my client over here didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
This is clearly a defamation.
Do you think that the fans are the internet conspirators? They're on point here. Or do you think it's just coincidence?
It could be a coincidence, man. Part of me wants it to be true, but I mean, at this point, we don't know anything. Man, I don't know. You would think that by now, they have everything down, but like we mentioned earlier, Marvel always changes shit, you know. So
especially when everybody knows the story already.
The worst fucking secret.
I think people are just getting really anxious because they don't want to give us a trailer. They don't because everybody already knows. They don't want to do nothing. They don't want to. They're like, let's just stay quiet and see.
You
how
look
long.
Like Chappelle. Like, give me some cocaine, some heroin.
People are getting desperate. You don't even know.
Yeah, bro.
People are getting desperate because somewhere in Middle America, theaters have gone as far as to putting up fake posters. For Spider-Man No Way Home. These are posters that assholes made on the internet on Photoshop. Because if you go and you type... No, I'm telling you, these are fake. I've seen these images before on people's thumbnails on YouTube and shit. So these are fake. But theaters don't give a fuck. They said, we need to get people back in here and make some money. Let's just start putting fake posters so people can get excited.
Oh my god.
What do you think of this shit, man?
I know. I was a jackass who fucking opened those things up and put it in there just to be funny. I don't think it's the theaters, bro. Come on. They can get fucking sued by this.
No, they can't. Man.
They can.
It's not real.
It's exactly. That's why. You idiot.
I don't know.
That's their fucking, like, you can't sue me. It's not real. What do you mean we're seeing it right there? Nope, the movie is not. That movie never does not exist.
There hasn't been a trailer.
The judge is like, I'm sick of this shit. Get the fuck out of
I'm sick of this shit. Somebody bring me the trailer so I can see it now.
Yeah. So we can't.
Son of a bitch! Yeah. Okay, everybody did a good effort. They all planned it out.
Anyways,
it was a bunch of nerds.
Enough with all this fucking nerd bullshit, Spider-Man crap. Let's get into the real issue.
All right.
But apparently, Black Widow is a failure.
Oh, really?
So apparently, this movie has a budget around $200-$250 million. They don't want to say. It's just an estimate. Worldwide, total, it's already made $255 million. It's broken even. It might have cost more, man, with promotion, you know, all of this bullshit. It's not making money. It's the first Avenger, Captain America, the first Avenger, the first movie that they made a long time ago, made more money than this fucking movie.
Yeah, well, duh. People were spending money on fucking theaters.
Yeah. You know? One good thing is that they have found out, and in a way, Disney's kind of proud of this, though. They said that a lot of people want to watch this and have seen this. And the proof is in the fact that this has become the number one most pirated movie on the internet.
Look, man. They're gonna get their money back when they put it out on fucking Blu-ray and 4K. That's when they're gonna get their money.
And selling toys and t-shirts and all that bullshit.
Yeah. They make all this money from that. Look, the movie maybe didn't appeal to a lot of guys out there because they don't care much about this. They fucked up on the fucking villain. That's for sure. You know? I was like, what the fuck? Like, that's not the guy that I was expecting. But at the end of the fucking day, people are going to buy the fucking DVD because they want to have the whole collection. They want to have everything. And they want to keep it for themselves, bro. Even the people who downloaded the movie, they're going to buy the movie.
Here's the real issue is, and it's not that right now, they probably have broken even, if anything, close to even. Because it might be a little bit more than 250 the budget. I don't know. Yeah. But if anything, they've broken at least even. They are going to make profit from this. You're right. From all the shit you described, they're going to make profit of it. But these greedy sons of bitches wanted a $1 billion paycheck. Like every movie they usually get. They're used to getting $1 billion from us. They're not going to get it anymore. They're going to have to figure out ways. They're going to have to figure out ways to fucking get that $1 billion from us in other ways. What worries me is that this has brought the attention to them that this is now... Look, the number one pirated movie last week in the world was Chris Pratt's... what was that movie called? The War of Tomorrow. Oh, Kike!
Yeah.
No, my dog's sneezing in the background. Kike, you have to watch the fucking War of Tomorrow.
I'll watch it tonight.
It's fucking sick. It's fucking amazing, bro. I loved it.
It's on Netflix, right?
It's on Amazon.
Amazon. Okay, I got it.
Yeah. It's fucking amazing. But anyways, that used to be the number one most pirated movie in the world. Well, now, right now, currently, it's Black Widow. And Disney knows that. And they mentioned that and they said, hey, we're not making money, but everyone's watching the movie.
Yeah, they're fans. Yeah. Dude, it's the same thing like back in the day when we used to fucking like.
You think that's gonna fuck people like me over and Disney's gonna start doing something about all this pirating shit?
No, because that's where you fucking get your word out. Dude, comics do shows for fucking nothing so they can get their fucking name out there.
These are $250 million nothings, bro.
Yes, exactly. They're gonna get their money back. Trust me. The more people watch it, the more famous it's gonna get. The more people are gonna fucking go see it.
I still feel
plus,
like what they need.
Back in the day, movies would stay on fucking theaters for a month.
Look, what they need to learn to do is to literally film the way Mandalorian films. You cut costs because you don't need all these people on set. Your set is like a dome.
Mm-hmm.
and you don't have to go to travel to another country and put your actors at risk and shit. Yeah. And if there's any old people, you don't have to even have them there. Just scan their faces and shit. Like, the you can make these movies for $100 million. You cut all the staff because you don't need all of them. You film in these small little studios where everything's not real. And the movie still looks amazing. Look at The Mandalorian. Half of the shit was more than half of the shit wasn't even real. The backgrounds weren't even real. And I believe they were. I thought they were in some exotic locations and they were in some fucking dome.
Shit. Yeah. Thing is, like, those domes aren't big enough for stunt people to do those crazy car chases and motorcycles.
They can make big domes, bro.
Well, I mean, we'll see. I mean, the one that I saw was big, was huge, but it's not enough for an action movie, you know? Well, so it wouldn't work for this movie in specific. Maybe for other ones.
Let's move on from Black Widow's failure, and let's talk about some other shit. We have some actual leaks coming from South America or Mexico or Spain. It's one of those countries in the south.
Okay, which one?
I don't know, bro. But I understand some of the words that are coming out there.
Is this the video that you talked about earlier?
It's a leak. Yeah, it's a leak. It's basically a behind the scenes. Okay. This is like when you go to the theaters and they're playing stuff before the previews and they give you sneak peeks at movies. This is one of those sneak peeks and they're showing the director and shit talking about the movie and they're showing clips of the movie and shit. So, like, we're seeing new footage here, leaks from the fucking movie.
Yeah.
I don't know. It looks fucking weird.
It's Portuguese.
We do see a shriek, you know. We see more of Carnage. It's Portuguese. Is that what it is?
Yeah, it is.
We see, like, dude, it just looks so cool. That shriek right there.
Mm-hmm. As far as what they're saying, nothing really important. It's just flatteries, you know. This actor's talking about Tom and blah blah blah, and some of the scenes how they would tape. Nothing substantial to say talk about, but yeah, the substantial thing here is that, like, we have some scenes of the movie.
Yeah, that we hadn't seen before.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool, man. I mean, whatever. I mean, I'm excited. We'll see. I'm
Hopefully,
excited
it's better than
the
first fucking movie.
Well, it's not. I'm still gonna watch it. I am. Yeah. I want to see Carnage.
Yeah, this is a movie I would not pay to go watch for real.
Right on, brother. Cheers.
Not because of that, you idiot. I'm just never gonna pay for this.
Don't you worry about it. Anyways, I need to get another beer. I'm sure this guy does too. So we'll be right back.
Watch me trick Fred out of his Cocoa Pebbles.
What happened, Coco? What's wrong?
I can't keep fighting crime unless I get something super chocolatey.
You need my delicious Cocoa Pebbles.
Mmm, truly super chocolatey.
Barney, my pebbles.
Guess it's time to bowl.
Oh, come back. Cheers.
Cheers.
You didn't even get a new drink, you dumbass.
No, it's right here. It's right here. I haven't finished the other one. Jeez.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know what to
do. Calm down, Susie. Jeez.
I was like, shit. This guy still has the same empty cup. Anyways, let's get into it. But apparently, that Snyder, you know, those fans that were trying to get the Snyderverse, and they were going to do this motion comment of the next two Justice League movies, they've been canceled. Already, it's been a week since they announced it, and they're canceled.
Yeah, of course.
Partially, apparently because of plagiarism. Because they traced the drawings from the comic books. Let me show you some of these images. Here's the Flash. We have the Flash. I mean, what do you think? You think they copied it? You think they traced it? You're looking at the Flash?
No, they didn't trace this. It's just a movement. How many comic books have you seen where the Flash has this fucking movement?
Okay.
How many fucking comic books have you seen where the Spider-Man goes like this?
Yeah. Okay. So we're gonna go one by one.
All right.
So this was not plagiarism.
No.
Okay. Yeah. I'm with you on that one. We'll go one by one.
Yeah.
Here's the next one. It's a Wonder Woman posing.
Yeah.
with the armor.
Yeah, that right there.
Similar facial structure.
That right there is Tracy. Like, even though the face doesn't look as good as the first one. I mean, they did an amazing job by photoshopping coloring. Like, they photoshopped
coloring. Altered.
Yeah, but like, the face obviously is not as good as the first one. And it is Tracy. Come on, bro. Like, that's the same fucking pose. Yeah. Same fucking dress or cape, right, whatever you want to call it.
I'm with you on this one. This is plagiarism.
Right. Yeah.
Here's the next image. Number three. We got a Superman doing a pose with a very similar facial structure.
Yeah. Neck, face. Yeah, yeah, the jawline.
The mouth pose is different.
Oh, well, yeah, because it's not as good of a fucking artist. Duh. Again, whoever's doing the coloring, he's doing a fantastic job. He's right on. Coloring, perfect.
Right.
Plus, whenever you color, you're not plagiarizing.
So we have the two plagiarizing, so one legit.
Uh-huh.
Here's the next image. Green Lantern. Same pose.
Let me blur it so they won't notice. It's the same fucking picture, basically.
Let me make the eyes white and the teeth really white.
Let me just unhinge his jaw. So it wouldn't be the same.
Oh my god. Three plagiarizing.
Yeah.
And then last one here. There's probably more, but we're going to stop this last one.
Let me mirror it. Just flip it, mirror it.
Oh god.
And it's not the same it's not the same leg.
He's not going to hold a batarang on
it's not raining. It's a thunderstorm. It's different, okay? So it's not plagiarizing.
Oh my god, dude. How dare these motherfuckers tarnish the legacy that the Man of the Year left behind?
Oh my god.
I don't know.
It's even the same gargoyle. Look at the gargoyle. They could have used a different gargoyle. They used the same one.
Plagiarizers. Oh, fucking losers. Why would you think they did this?
Because they want to do it as quickly as possible. So they're like, we're just gonna copy the same thing, and then we just change, you know, this and that, and voila, new fucking graphics and images.
It would not have cost you that much to pay an artist, an amateur, mm-hmm, to draw you a few scenes.
Yeah, but they don't know the art. These are amateurs.
Yeah,
people are like, like I said, whoever's doing the Photoshop coloring is doing a great job. Look. Whoever's doing the drawings is clearly copying from the fucking original, you know, drawings.
Yeah, you're right. The artist, they fucked up. They need to pay a real artist, but already they've been tarnished and they've been canceled. You know how the internet works. They're done. Yeah. All right, they're done. Anyways, let's move on to the Man of the Year. Since we're talking about him, because Mr. Zack Snyder and his wife Deborah Snyder, who are also part owners of the Stone Quarry, the film company, their film production company, has now landed a 2-year deal to supply Netflix with content.
Oh wow!
For an undisclosed amount of money.
Pretty sure it's a lot of money. Netflix has a lot of fucking money.
Zack Snyder said, "Hey, Warner Media, I don't need you. Discovery, I got my new pals over here."
I'm glad for him. Good for him.
Yeah, the Man of the Year, man. This guy is gonna make so much money. Like, he's gonna do all the fucking movies he wants to make.
Look, that fucking zombie movie. Just because of the effort and the time they spent on deleting, canceling an actor and putting someone else in there, that to me was like, wow, they really cared about it, because you can't even tell. A lot of scenes. But there's some scenes there were like shit that
was,
whoa,
blurred. No, there was some scenes. There was a lot of shit that was blurred and shit and a half.
Yeah. There was a lot, but some of them deserve my recognition, man.
Look, they did good.
Yeah.
I think maybe they didn't have enough time.
Mm-hmm.
Because a little bit more time, it could have looked a lot better.
Look, man, I wouldn't even fucking take the guy out. I mean, whatever.
Our technology is almost there. It's almost there.
Yeah, it's almost there.
Sure. I'm sure the government has it, the real stuff.
Dude, we're going to have, like, in the future, we're going to have movies with people who already died, actors, on his amazing comeback.
We already do fucking Peter Cushing's and fucking Star Wars, right. Your ass.
But
let's move on. Let's move on. Enough of this shit. Actually, kind of related topic, because since we're talking about Zack Snyder, a past movie he did direct for Warner in the past was Man of Steel, where he got started the DC Universe. He started the DC Universe with his Man of Steel movie. And the screenwriter, David Goyer, has recently made some interviews, and he's come out and he said something very fucking interesting about some of the notes the studio sent back to him about the script. And the movie, when they first saw the movie, the notes, fix this, or how about this, the changes.
The suits.
Yeah, the suits. He goes, one note I got was on Man of Steel, where the ending involves Superman utilizing the pod that he arrived in as a child in order to bring down Zod's ship. The note that we got from the studio was, you have to change that. And we called them and we were like, why? And they told us, because if Superman uses the pod and it's destroyed while saving the city, how is he ever going to go back to his home of Krypton? And we just stayed quiet, and we were all like, Krypton blew up in the beginning, the first 30 minutes, remember?
My God, dude.
Did you not see it? Do you remember? It's in the beginning of the movie.
They were nice enough to fucking show them for that. You know, you think that an executive would know the background of the movie?
No, the premise? They saw the movie. The comic books. They saw the movie from the beginning, and these are the notes they sent back to change. And he's like, did you not see the beginning of the movie? Like, the planet is destroyed. Why does he want to go back to his home?
Exactly. Like, they can't fucking even fucking, like, see that from the beginning of the movie. What are they fucking doing? I mean, like, that's why I would pay big money to get executives that know about the fucking lore. You know, if you want to be an executive, you need to know about it, man.
This is why Marvel is successful and DC is the reality. This is why they're successful. You're right. There's people that don't know what the fuck they're reading. They don't know what the fuck they're reading. They're not even paying attention to the old material they just show. But anyways, because this is the old company. We know now that it's been merged, and it's a fucking Warner Media Discovery. And Warner Media Discovery is ordering HBO Max. It's ordering Warner Brothers Studios, to make 10 original movies for HBO Max next year.
In what original movies in what sense? Like
actual comic movies. Book movies? No, like movies you would release in theaters. Like,
okay, gotcha.
We want you to make, like he told Warner Brother Pictures, Warner Brother Studios, fucking make 10 good movies, original movies, for fucking HBO Max for next year.
That's good.
Yeah. That's good. So Discovery is on the move already. We're going to make money. Yeah. We're going to make money with the apps. I think they're figuring out, like, the theaters are dying, bro. They are dying. And they're figuring it out, and they said, we need to invest in the apps. We need to put fucking good quality fucking shit on these things so people can subscribe and keep subscribing. Because every year, that shit's going to go up. I mean, my Sling went up another $5. They sent me an email and shit.
Shit, they haven't sent me one.
They're going to, I promise you. Anyways. moving on. HBO Max, I mean, Warner Media is not stopping there. Because apparently... they're doing The Last of Us, an HBO series, and they have casted Pedro Pascal and Bella Ramsey in the lead roles.
Isn't she the little girl from Ant-Man?
I don't know who she is.
I don't know. She looks like her. Maybe all kids to me look the same.
Yeah. I mean, it's the way I see them. Yeah. They all look the same. Yeah, they have different skin tones, but they all look the same. Little kids. I mean, they're interesting roles. I guess they're going for younger looks for both of them, because he still kind of looks kind of young. But it's cool. I mean, I buy it. But look, this is what I'm talking about. That Warner Discovery is not holding back on their investment. Each episode of the series, and I don't know how many there's going to be, because I'm fucking drunk and high and I don't want to do research. But each episode is estimated to cost at least $10 million.
Oh, wow.
Each episode and has a budget of $10 million. And they said that at the end of the show, it's probably going to be in the hundreds of millions of dollars.
Guess what, buddy? I'm going to watch these series.
I'm telling you, bro. They're not holding back. They're spending their money like they just merged companies. And they said, we got to fucking start giving Disney some competition.
Yeah, bro. Because HBO was the big fucking shit. And
look, let's be honest.
Disney's killing it, man.
Look, let's be honest, though. Disney is just for your kids. All these apps, like Amazon and HBO Max, they have this shit for us. They really do. The shows that are made for us. Game of Thrones. You know, all the shows you like to watch and shit. They're all on these apps. Everybody's been watching them and shit. And Disney just focuses on kids. And all they have, really, is Marvel. Because everything else, dude, people already had that in their libraries. All those old movies, they already had those for their kids.
The Vault.
Yeah, who did not have all that shit for their kids already?
Yeah.
It's like when they turn on the app, they don't watch that shit because they've already had Peter Pan and Pinocchio there on your DVD, Blu-rays, and shit.
But now it's remastered.
Fuck you. They don't watch them. They don't watch them. I've heard my friends say, yeah, we have it, and all the kids watch Marvel movies because they already have
Nobody has a fucking tape.
They grew up seeing all that shit anyways, all because everybody's seeing the DVDs. That's all they have. So they're pumping money into their apps is what I'm just basically trying to say. Another guy who is popping up is Michael B. Jordan, bro. Because what apparently happened? He is also putting in his money, and he's producing with HBO Max Superman, Black Superman.
Oh, so he's actually making it himself.
Now, I don't know if he's going to star in it. But he's putting in money. He's going to produce. And him and some of these new screenwriters were very adamant about this not being Clark Kent. Because they said, why do we want to, like, race wash a white character? Mm-hmm. Like, they said, Michael B. Jordan was saying, why do I want to race wash a white character? Like, there's already a black Kryptonian, Val Zod. Why do you want to dismiss the black Superman that's already in the comic books? He said that. And so now this is what he's trying to get made with HBO Max.
Well, look, I hope it's fucking good. Because this, let's be honest here, most of these Superman movies suck ass.
But this is not going to be Superman. This is going to be Val Zod.
I know. I want him to do good.
Different story.
So that, and if he's going to be the executive producer or whatever, I want him to show fucking DC, like, this is how it's made, bitches.
Yeah, you think he'll star in it?
Let's hope so. He's jacked already.
Yeah,
he can is. Be. He's a jacked up motherfucker.
He's big, man. He could.
Yeah.
He could. But something else that happened here on fucking HBO Max is that they casted their Batgirl, Leslie Grace. Really? This little, I thought she was Mexican, but her name's Leslie Grace.
Hey, nowadays you can't even tell, man.
I guess, yeah. Whatever. Maybe she's mixed. She's our new Barbara Gordon in the HBO Max movie that's coming. And she was in that movie In the Heights. You know, our friend dances in that movie.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Our friend's in that shit.
How old is she?
I don't know, dude. She looks young. She's probably
okay, and then I'll shut up.
Yeah, you probably should, pervert.
I will.
You're gonna end up like Drake Bell. You wanna end up like Drake Bell? There's some other like fucking badass DC shit that's been happening, dude. And I'm excited about it. I only collect fucking TMNT comic books, but apparently DC Comics is about to make a new series, comic book series, and it follows the story of Batman 1989.
Woo!
After part two.
Woo! I love it when I'm right, and then it comes out more and more, and I'm fuck yeah, it's a good feeling to be right.
Yeah. But the artwork, bro, they
show amazing.
It looks amazing. I mean, you show Selena Kyle. That's a fucking Michelle Pfeiffer yeah. there. They show Billy yeah. Billy Dee Williams being Two-Face. Being Two-Face. And they show Marlon Wayans, who was supposed to be Robin in the next Tim Burton movie. These are actual fucking design concept art. And they fucking made him into comic books. And there's going to be a limited series of Batman 1989.
That's awesome.
Coming, I don't know, in a few weeks. That's crazy, bro.
Damn. 1980 now. How old is that? Like 33, 34 years old?
I mean, it's going to follow the story.
Damn.
What happened after?
Yeah.
It's fucking legit.
That's awesome.
It's fucking legit.
Yeah.
But let's move on to the main shit, bro. Why everyone's really here. The goddamn fucking Flash leaks. And we'll start off with the actual test footage. And we see first... Supergirl and this little Mexican girl, Supergirl, and we see fucking Ezra Miller looking like an idiot with a with short hair.
And dude, I had that fucking hair back when I was a kid.
You almost had that hair
in the 90s.
In that fucking the fucking yellow fucking hoodie or whatever.
Baggy fucking jean fucking like shirt.
Yeah. Supergirl looking all blue. With like red, I don't know, man. I wish her boots were red.
Yeah.
There's too much fucking blue.
There's too much.
This is test footage, raw test footage. This isn't with VFX and shit, so
yeah,
it might look better. But right now, I don't like it. But they showed us more pictures. They showed us the actual fucking filming. And it's a Barry Allen with short hair talking to another Barry Allen, the one we just saw in the test footage.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that in this movie, he's not going to go back in time. He's going to another reality because he also finds himself there.
Maybe he got lost in time and space. But it's himself. So that kind of makes you think...
He's talking to himself.
I don't know, man. And it's not like it's himself from the future in another dimension. It's himself in 1989, because you can see how he's dressed up with the high tops.
He's younger?
So, is he younger? I don't think so.
I thought it was an alternate reality, like multiverse.
Me too?
This isn't time. You're going back in time.
Yeah, I know.
So that's why there's another Barry Allen.
Oh, yeah, you're right. He is wearing some retro shit in this year, though. It's weird.
It's another reality.
Mm-hmm.
It's the reality of Batman 1989.
There's a lot of denim.
He is kind of dressed kind of funny. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, I need more pictures.
They showed some amazing pictures, though. They showed the Batcave, bro.
That looks fucking awesome.
It's a fucking ginormous set.
Yeah, bro. I'm glad they're using, like, this kind of shit, you know, like the old school
practical effects.
Yeah, bro. That looks awesome.
It looks very reminiscent of the old... I don't remember what the first Batcave looked like from 1989.
It was very dark, but it looked... Yeah, it had a center, and remember that the car would go up, and then it would go like this, and it would go on a ramp. So I don't know if they're going to build that, or maybe they're going to CGI, part this and that. But, I mean, if he's older, I mean, he maybe changed a little things in the Batcave. You never know.
He had the little elevator...
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it looks cool, man. I mean, obviously, there's gonna be
and they have the old car, bro.
The old fucking car,
dude.
It looks amazing. It looks just like it.
Yeah, it looks like it's like the fucking like airplane jet engine, basically in the middle of the car. That's fucking awesome.
That's fucking amazing.
Yeah, bro. I remember when that shit came on, and I was like, holy fuck, that's so cool.
So, where do you think all these pictures are coming from? Who's taking these pictures?
Ah, man, I don't know. But you can see on the first one where the bat fucking vehicle is, like, you can see Barry Allen in the back because it has wearing the same fucking weird haircut.
Where?
The same
jacket. Yeah, you're right. Right there.
So I don't know if these are test pictures for them as reference for lighting and, you know, the dress. But obviously the first ones where he's talking to himself, that's an actual, you know, the movie. That's the actual movie. But the car and the Batcave, obviously these are leaked out because probably some executive needed production pictures to make sure that they're making their job or some shit. I don't know. And he probably is an idiot and didn't fucking use a VPN and someone fucking like leaked all the pictures.
Something he left his laptop open.
And he has his password and the password with a fucking tape on it and a sticky note.
The temp goes in there yeah. With a USB drive and gets all this shit. And all this fucking shit, yeah.
That's how we're getting all these pictures.
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. It looks cool. It looks very promising. I mean, I like the route it's going. I like this route that they're going with, and I can't wait. It looks a little...
How do you think Supergirl is gonna fucking factor into this shit?
I don't know. I have no fucking clue. I have no fucking clue, but it will be interesting because, I mean, in this alternate world, whoever got saved was not Superman. It was a girl. Or there is a Superman, and this is his cousin or whatever. Or this is Batman's daughter. I mean, not Batman, Superman's daughter. See, I'm already confused. Shit.
Yeah, I don't
There's
know
a lot of things to factor in here.
There is a lot of stuff this could be. A million stuff this could be. Now, why is he talking to himself? Is he back in time? Talking to his younger self? Is he in another reality?
1989, this guy.
Is he just a few years before? I don't know.
Maybe he was talking to his dad?
No. Well, yeah, he could be his dad. That could be Billy Crudup. But yeah, I don't know, man. It's just so fucking weird what we've been seeing. The images, like, what is going on? Are we Batman 1989?
I'm pretty sure DC didn't meant to make us confused, but now that it's confusing, it's even more attractive. I want to know more because I don't know what the fuck is going on.
Do you think
doing a good job?
Hang on, dude. Do you think the reason why these motherfuckers make it seem like what the fuck is going on is because maybe they don't know what the fuck they're doing?
Maybe they don't know. You're right.
They're just the Marvel's going back in time, and there's multiverses. So why don't we go back in time? And there's Batman 1989.
The actor who's playing the Flash, he's like, so why am I talking to myself in 1989? I wasn't even born back then.
Don't worry, kid. You're gonna be famous. You're gonna be famous. We're gonna make toys.
Keep talking to yourself.
Keep talking to yourself. Don't worry about it. I hope this is gonna be. It looks good, but looks can be deceiving.
I know. I mean, we can only make up so many things in our head that will be, you know, that would make sense. Let's hope the movie makes sense. Well, I think this makes sense.
Dude,
check it out. Hear me out.
The things that I've said make sense, but they sound horrible to the plot of the movie. So that's what I'm like. I hope it's not any of those shits. Like,
that's what I'm saying. I was like, let's hope he's talking to his dad.
You know? Oh my god. I hope it's not his dad. That would be fucking weird.
Tell him like, hey, I made you know, don't read it until the date. They're gonna do the Back to the Future thing.
No. Well, look, they are dressed differently. So it's either. God, here we go. Look.
They are dressed differently, okay? We have that one going.
Okay, look. It's either he changed. I don't know. It's either he goes back in time and talks to himself in the past. in a day, or he goes to another reality.
So he never, he's always been the same size. When he's 8, he's already 6 feet tall.
You know what? You're right. It's not that. He's not going back in time. He goes to another reality, but okay. And this is another version of him.
In this other reality, it's always 1989.
Or it's Batman 1989. But is this Barry Allen, is this version of him, does he have the Flash powers?
Okay, forget about the whole 1989 thing. Forget about that.
Is the present time,
and he's talking to himself in a different reality. He's not going back in time. He's not.
No, he's not going back in time. He goes to another reality. He goes to another reality. This is himself in another reality.
Yeah.
Does this guy with the short hair, does he have powers like the one we know?
Like the Flash?
Yeah. Do you think he does?
He should. I don't see why he would lose his powers. No.
No, I think he doesn't have powers. And you know why? Uh-huh. If you go to the very first image.
Uh-huh.
Now, we already saw images of the Batmobile and the Batcave.
Yeah.
But if you go to the first image where we see Supergirl. If you look at the kid, then we see Barry Allen there, shocked or whatever. That's the Barry Allen from the other reality.
Yeah.
And he's in the Batcave, and he's amazed and shocked.
Yeah. This Barry Allen does not have powers. The Barry Allen with the short hair does have powers, because he's the one who across dimensions, right? Yeah. He's the one capable of doing so. This one does not have powers. And like you said, I think that's why he looks surprised.
Yeah.
Or maybe he's just Starstruck because he knows Batman. He probably does have powers. And he's acting like the fucking Flash from the movie, from the DC Universe, who's always like, oh, you're that Batman guy. Remember? You're rich, right?
Well, God damn it. I hope not. I hope he's not being a dumbass like that and shit. I'm excited about this. And I hope the trailer doesn't disappoint me, because that's what it's going to come down to, the trailer.
It's probably going to confuse us even more.
No, it's not. You know DC. DC is known for giving the whole movie away in the first trailer.
Yeah.
Right? DC will show you the movie in the first trailer. We saw Suicide Squad. The Suicide Squad, the new one that's going to come out. Because that's the name of it. The same fucking name. It's confusing explaining.
No, it's The Suicide Squad. The other one is Suicide Squad.
The new fucking movie. Piece of shit.
Maybe it's the other way around. I don't know.
Anyways,
again, DC. Confusing.
Confusing as fuck is what I'm trying to say. Alright, anyways, fuck this shit. I'm done with this. Let's just, you know what, Kike? Get these motherfuckers some life advice so we get the fuck out of here. I'm fucked up already.
If you ever decide to make a movie, make sure that person is not over 80, doesn't have fragile bones, arthritis, and if you are gonna promote this actor, make sure you have a stunt double that looks just like him, so you can deepfake his face.
And he's 40 years younger, you idiot.
Yeah, at least.
Making him do flips and rehearsing and shit. And all this fucking yoga, and you're gonna flip this guy over your back and he's gonna tumble. It's gonna look awesome.
Don't worry, Mr. Ford. You landed a plane and almost died, and you made it.
That was 10
years ago.
All right, we're
nobody
done,
can kill you.
Oh, God. God bless you, Mr. Harrison Ford. God bless you. Cheers.
We salute you, man.
Cheers.
Oh, Jesus. Cheers.